Hi, I'm Dr. Christopher Burton. Thanks for being with me on this video today. I want to talk about mommy guilt. Now, obviously, I'm not a mommy, but I do know several. My wife is a physician mom, my sister-in-law is a physician mom, and several of my good friends from medical school happen to be physician moms. I've been able to talk with them, and I've come to the conclusion that the roles that they have as a physician and a mother sometimes compete and increase their risk of burnout and make it more challenging for them to meet those struggles that I may face or that some of our male physician colleagues face. And as I listen to the physician moms, there's this guilt they feel for being away from the children. I don't like to be away from home, but it's not the same thing, obviously, as it is for a mother. One physician mom I spoke to said that, I work full time. I feel like I don't have enough help. My family's not close by. Her husband's also a physician who works long hours, and she feels, he's not even able to help much at home. They've got two toddlers, which I can attest to is the challenge no matter who you are. She went on to share that, she felt fatigue and she felt even more guilty because when she is at home, she feels like there's so many things that she needs to do to take care of the house. And she envisions that other physician moms are probably able to prepare these wholesome meals, to keep the house spick and span, to have quality time with their spouse and their children. She hates going, even to the park because she dreads coming home and finding even more things that have piled up on that to-do list. Her story is hardly unique, though. It's something I've heard many times. In fact, I really enjoy doing workshops for this reason. I get to hear feedback from the audience as opposed to just telling stories from the stage. Well, when some of those physician moms responded, they were able to share some of the things that worked for them to take some of the stress out of their life and help them kind of combat the mommy guilt, if you will. One of the most repeated suggestions I heard was making sure to get enough help. Obviously first most common was family. If you have family nearby, having them help out, followed by babysitters, house cleaners, and lawn care. Those are pretty common things that you can outsource and take some of that load off of your plate. Another idea that resonated was finding meal services that will either deliver food or even deliver prepared food to your home on a regular basis. And there's a lot of those out there now that you can choose from. In fact, most mainstream grocery stores will even do your shopping for you, have it ready for you to pick up, or some of them even deliver now as well, which when you don't have time to wander through the aisles of a store, it makes a huge difference. Once you get some of those things off of your plate, you have more free time, you're able to enjoy spending time with your kids. You're gonna have less stress, less guilt, because you're able to enjoy the time you spend with them and you're able to focus on them wholeheartedly instead of being distracted by worrying about the things that you aren't getting done during that time. Some of the things that the physician moms also talked about that helped them were exercising on a regular basis, even if it was something simple, just like walking or going to the park with the kids. Something active definitely helps, and we know that the benefits of exercise are amazing. None of us do it enough, but it does help relieve stress and does get rid of some of that anxiety that a lot of us feel about not meeting the goals we have set for ourselves. Another thing was just eating well. The junk food we pick up in the cafeteria or donuts lying around in the hospital, those things make us feel bad. We get a little sugar rush, but then we crash afterwards. And then, the inevitable weight gain, self-image issues. There's a lot of that stuff that eating healthy, eating clean definitely improves. It makes us feel better about ourselves and makes us feel actually more energetic over time when we're not bouncing from sugar rush to caffeine fix back to sugar rush all the time. Some of the other things that they mentioned were making sure to get enough sleep, even if it meant that some of the chores didn't get done. Sleep is imperative. Any of us that have gone through the the residency years can attest to what it's like when you don't get enough sleep. It's not good for anyone, not good for us, and not good for those that we interact with either, because we can't be our best if we're not well rested. And then for mental stimulation, things like listening to audiobooks or podcasts while they're driving, commuting, that kind of can either be for your own personal growth, professional development, or just for enjoyment and relaxation. Something to kind of ease the stress and take your mind off of it. Now, again, my wife reminds me quite frequently, there's no amount of logic or rationalization from my male brain that's going to take away the mommy guilt. But you know, even if I tell her the kids are going to grow up, you know, happy, healthy, and well-adjusted, if the dishes aren't done and the laundry isn't folded, that doesn't help. What helps is finding ways to help unload those burdens off of her plate, whether it's the grocery shopping, finding someone to help clean the house, do those chores so that she can have free time to enjoy the kids without that burden hanging over her head, feeling like she's torn between what she should be doing with that time. So now, when she does have time to play, she can focus on that instead of what chores are not being done. And I hope you found these suggestions helpful. I listed some specific tools on a worksheet, and you can go to ChristopherBurtonMD.com/mommy. That's ChristopherBurtonMD.com/mommy. Download the specific tools. That's companies who do food delivery, companies help out with personal assistance to do tasks like running errands, the groceries, picking up the groceries, picking up the dry cleaning, running errands, those sorts of things, and a few bonus ones to help as well. I hope you found this helpful. If there's any suggestions you have, or if you just want to talk about other ideas that may be helpful for you too to decrease that stress and the burden that you feel, please reach out and contact me. I'm always looking to learn new things and share new ideas. Thank you very much. Again, it's ChristopherBurtonMD.com/mommy for your free tools. Have a good day.